Namaskar, welcome to Hospitality Leadership Series. Ladies and gentlemen, with us today we have Chef Gunjan Goila, who is a celebrity chef, an ambassador to Indian vegetarian cuisine to the world, a female who has given Indian vegetarian cuisine a new dimensions, an inspiration to many, has contributed to many food magazines, publications, TV shows, and not many to her profile. We welcome you, ma'am, to our
show. Thank you so much for calling me.
Chef, first and foremost, being a female chef, how do you view this profession as a director of School of Hospitality and Tourism in India? I frequently come across this question when the parents or the students, they come to my office and ask that we intend to pursue hospitality management program and our daughter intends to be a chef. Of course, that gender issue may not be across the globe, but then particularly in many parts of India, people have such type of queries. How do you see the role of a female chef in our industry and how safe and good is it? Please let our audience know.
To begin with, let me tell you, being a woman chef myself, I was encouraged by my parents. During those times, there were not very many women chefs, as you just put it up. And the question, the first thing that your opening line was that the parents want their daughters to be in this profession. That itself is so encouraging. And I'm glad that this awakening is happening in India, because this was very predominant in Europe and in America, where there was equality, the girl child was considered at par with the boy. Thankfully, this culture is coming to India and you see so many women chef coming up. And when you go to the institute, when I go to lecture or do something, I find, and it's very, very heartening to see young girls coming up and asking me questions. See, like all professions, even this profession has certain, I shouldn't say a stigma, but certain other part of every profession, this too also has, which every lady has to bear. Because wherever you're working, there will be areas of trouble, there will be areas of shortcomings. A woman has to wear so many hats. She has to be a mother. When she gets married, she'll have a child. She has to be a wife and she has to be a daughter-in-law to the in-laws, because ours is a joint family society. She also has to be a daughter to her parents. And now getting into the wearing a hat of a woman chef has its own set of enigmas, or you can say a style of working. So, I think that's a woman's luck, or God has granted that to a woman, that she can get away with anything and she can come out as a very clean winner. So even if she's working with late nights in the hotel, she can manage it because she has that feeling in her where she has compassion for her child, for her profession and for her family. Now food itself requires a lot of love, which a woman is best bestowed with. True. You know, she's the one who can go back to the husband who's in trouble to ruffle his hair and say, get up and I'm there to pep you. She'll even take care of a child, and in the morning when she comes to the kitchen, she'll be most conscious what to cook, how to deliver. And she'll put in a heart and soul into that food. And I think that's very important, because cooking needs all that. I always tell everybody, whichever forum or wherever I get a chance to speak, that you have to be present mentally and physically when you're cooking. You just can't cook like, you know, when your heart is elsewhere and you're chopping your vegetables. Till such time you feel for it, food doesn't taste good. Because food would only taste with your feelings. Once you mix those feelings, your ingredients, the dish, what comes out is eternal love. So it's very important, and I think a woman is bestowed with all this. Not that I mean you are a male, you don't have, you do have a lot of male chefs in this domain.
True.
But a woman is, it's a God's gift to her. That's what I would say.
So ladies and gentlemen, Chef Gunjan Goila has given a fantastic preview about, and you don't have to bother in case if you are a female and you're looking forward for a career for being a female chef. There is an exciting career, and of course, there are challenges for all people, all genders, in the life. So let's be ready to face those challenges. But as such, I don't see that there is any problem that if you are a female and you intend to be a chef, you can be a meticulous and a fantastic and an amazing chef who can perform a good culinary voice and be an ambassador to the cuisine of India to the world. Now, chef, you are a strong promoter of Indian vegetarian food, Indian vegetarian cuisine. Often we see there are debates going on in the society and people when we talk about food, that the non-vegetarian food that, appeals your taste buds. And people often say, what's there in the vegetarian cuisine? So let our audience know that what are the brighter aspects of vegetarianism or vegetarian cuisine of India. Let the world know about it.
All right. Tell me, if you make a section of a vegetarian section and a non-vegetarian section, I would say if you start counting the number of vegetables, you'll have a very long list. You start with ghee, tori, tinda, mutter, gobi, aloo, zucchini, and so on. I think it'll take me another 10 minutes to list down. When you come to non-vegetarian, you have chicken, you have mutton, you have fish, or you can say a seafood world. But tell me one thing. Suppose you were to make one chicken. Do you have any season for it? No, you get chicken round the season. But when you come to the vegetarian world, you have seasonality. You will find ghee only in summers because it is meant to be eaten in summer.
True.
There is a certain climatic condition which your body needs to have that particular food that's healing to you. Now, when you have aam in summers, because mango is a fruit eaten during that time, which is cooling to your stomach and it will cool down your thirst, it will cool down your heat in the body. Coming to winters, you have gobhi or mutter. Now, those are the seasonal vegetables that your digestive system needs, and you need to have certain bacteria from gobhi and mutter, which is good for your gut. Now, coming to chicken, you have one chicken which you will eat throughout the season. How many types you can do it, but see the endless variety, the nature bounty, what has God given to you. And there is an endless way of preparing it.
True.
Now, each vegetable has its distinct taste. Chicken would taste chicken whichever way you cook. But if you come to the vegetarian world, each vegetable needs a different handling. It needs a different kind of spices and needs a different kind of cooking, which you need to understand and which will bring more taste and more variety to you. And definitely you'll enjoy a bigger variety or a bigger spread on the table rather than eating, the certain fixed meal that you get to eat. When people say that what is the kick that you get in the vegetable, I think the colors. Look at the colors nature has given you for the vegetarian world. You have green, yellow, red, black, and the list is endless. And you also need to have colors in your system. You also need to have colors for your eyes. As the saying goes, food is first eaten with your eyes. So when you see a different color in your plate, isn't it more exciting than seeing the same color with the set of vegetarian or the non-vegetarian food? So I feel, a vegetarian feast is much more challenging and more exciting to have in your plate.
Fantastic. So lucidly and fantastically, Chef Gunjan has elaborated upon vegetarian cuisine of India and its beauty. And you see, she has a rationale in her talk when she's citing that it's a gift of Mother Nature that summers you get mangoes and winters you get peas. And how can Mother Nature be disturbing to her kids? So Mother Nature has gifted different vegetarian foods along with their seasons, which are to support you and supplement you in terms of your health. As chefs and academicians in hospitality and tourism, we pay respect to all kind of food and cultures across the world. But then simultaneously, we advocate that what Mother Nature has gifted to us, that is always a blessing and we can always relish it all the times. Before we move ahead to the closing of this series today, Chef, I have a question, that what is this slow food concept about? Quickly, if you can let our audience know about, and how India has an association with its culture for the slow food.
Slow food is no rocket science. India always had slow food. It is just that it is transported from India to Europe. Well, tell me one thing. Did ever our farmers grow anything else, or did they ever use anything else except the organic dung which was used as a manure?
No, I think rather that was the most encouraged thing, and that was a part of sustainability. The cattle dungs was being converted into manures, and that was used in a great way to the farms.
Correct. Now, you are answering the question yourself rather than my giving any inputs. Now, what has happened is we always cooked food on slow fire. When you say what is slow food, now slow food is not, okay, to make the audience a little more understanding is you can say diagonally opposite to the fast food like McDonald's. Now the slow food organization based in Turin by this gentleman called Carlo Petroni was actually a fight against Coke and McDonald's because their culture was totally dependent on the fast food. Now the reason, see, now there are certain factors to it because husband and wife both are working. When they both are working, who's going to cook in the kitchen?
Correct.
And when do they have the time to do that? But coming back to India, wives were always meant to run the family. It was the husband's duty to earn, get the money, and it is the ladies of the house who will run the kitchen, manage the kitchen and sustain the family. So they were always bothered about the health of their family. They would just choose the fresh vegetables. They would see the best way to consume that because we never had fridges. So whatever was cooked in the morning, so many times the food was not even reheated. Now you see, what is this? This is just controlling the nutrients and the bacteria. We were not consuming the same food in the evening. Whereas you go back to Europe, that food is cooked in a very big kitchen and sent to these to the various out channels and to all the establishments where they were selling the food, and which was called a burger patty. Now they were just heating the food which was cooked 10 days back and given. That was not very good for your health. But in India, we always had fresh fruits, fresh vegetables and freshly cooked food for that particular meal. So India always maintained the slow food philosophy. We were not into cokes. We had chikanji, we had mattha, we had lassi, what they call as smoothies. We always had, but Ayurveda never prescribed fruit and curd together. It was against the Ayurvedic principles. Whereas those people, the Europeans didn't have the concept of Ayurvedic. So they were mixing fruit and curd, fruit and milk. So the milkshakes came up and the smoothies came up. But India, everybody was following the Ayurvedic principles. We hardly had any, who would eat a cold drink or, a spasmodon for a stomachache. You would go to a veggie and he would prescribe you a kada, which was freshly done. So these are all the fundamental principles of slow food. And India was a pioneer, and I still is a pioneer in maintaining the slow food philosophy.
So fantastic, dear audience. You have got to know about slow food. So eat slow food, live healthier, live happier and live long. Before we say bye-bye to our today's show, I would like to request Chef Kunjan to quickly give 3 tips to the budding chefs and the people across the world about what she feels food, vegetarianism and life is.
I always have one message, the 3 P's. Now these 3 P's are patience, practice and presence. Patience, you understand that when you're cooking, you cannot do anything in a jiffy. There are no shortcuts to cooking. If you want a good, perfect meal, please have patience. Presence. Now, presence does not mean that you have to be there. The presence means your presence. Your presence of your mind, body and soul into the food. And unless until all the 3 connect, you will not be able to achieve the perfect food that you want for yourself and your family. And it is practice that makes it perfect. So keep practicing, you will be a winner one day.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for joining our hospitality leadership series. Dear audience, should you like this video, press like button, subscribe button and share it, and also press the bell button, alarm button, so that we can alert you with our forthcoming videos. You watch our videos on India Host channel. We'll keep coming with exciting videos more and more for you. You keep inspiring us by liking, sharing and alarming those videos. With this, we have a great time with you and Chef Gunjan Goela. Thank you. Thank you so very much, ma'am. Namaskar.
Namaskar. Thank you so much.